Hello flying friends, and welcome to another episode of where I try and answer popular aviation and travel questions from the point of view of a pilot. If you're brand new to the channel, welcome along. Now, my name's Stefan, I'm a private pilot. I also like, and sorry, I'm not sure what that was. What was I saying? Yeah, my name's Stefan, I'm a private pilot.
Ladies and gentlemen, captain, turn on the fastest seatbelt signs as we will be going through an area of turbulence.
It stopped. Anyway, in all seriousness, turbulence sucks. And that's what we're here to talk about today. Turbulence. As pilots, we actively try and avoid turbulence. I mean, it's a really inefficient way to fly, it's uncomfortable, and in some instances, it can be a serious jeopardy to the safety of the aircraft. And as a passenger, I really don't like it either. Nobody enjoys it when you're sitting on a plane, that seatbelt sign comes on, and the plane starts to rock around and you start to go through those bumps. We all agree, turbulence sucks. But what causes turbulence, and what are the different sorts of turbulence that an aircraft can experience? Well, let's put 600 feet on the altimeter, and let's take a look at the four main types of turbulence. The first sort is called thermal turbulence, or sometimes convective turbulence. Warm air from the sun heats the earth, the moisture in the air rises, as we know, hot things rise, condenses and causes clouds. Now, clouds are fine, planes can fly through clouds, we do it all the time. But when you get those areas of air that are relatively unstable, and all of a sudden you get one of those big, towering, fluffy, cauliflower-looking cumulonimbus storm clouds. These clouds are bad for a couple of reasons, but mainly for an aircraft. Those fast-moving up and down currents, or updrafts and downdrafts, can often cause damage to an airplane if it flies through it. But the good news is, modern aircraft, the commercial airliners and some of the smaller ones as well, have often got radar on board or a storm scope, and they can see these areas of high convective activity up ahead. And what do? We avoid them. The second sort of turbulence is what's called mechanical or mountain wave turbulence. Now, the wind traveling around the world normally travels in a relatively calm way if there's nothing to disturb it. But the moment it comes to an obstacle like a mountain in this case, the air starts to rise and then gravity pulls it down and it falls. And then momentum pulls it back up and then it falls again and so on, creating this wave effect on the downwind side of the mountain. And any plane flying through that is obviously going to get affected by those up and down currents. The third type of turbulence is wind shear, or sometimes referred to as jet stream turbulence. Now, jet streams are those fast moving currents of air that work their way around the globe, a bit like fast moving currents in a stream of water. And on the edge of those currents, you get areas of air which are moving at slightly different speeds, and that's called wind shear. Now, that wind shear can sometimes cause turbulence, but the good news is this turbulence is fairly rare, and also it's normally fairly light. And the final type of turbulence, one that you might not have thought of, it's actually the turbulence caused by other aircraft. I need a prop, 1 second. When a plane flies through the air, high pressure is generated below the wing, lower pressure above it. When those two meet at the edge of the wingtip, they actually spill backwards in a spiral that moves its way behind the aircraft. Now, generally, the larger the aircraft, the more lift it's generating, and the larger these wingtip vortices are. And for aircraft behind it, especially smaller planes, these can be something that you really do want to avoid. Now, if you are a nervous passenger, let me leave you with one final thought. Rest assured that pilots all around the world will do whatever they can to actively avoid flying through areas of turbulence. As I mentioned, modern aircraft have sophisticated equipment on board to be able to see these areas up ahead of them, and pilots will simply divert around them. If you can't go around the turbulence, sometimes what pilots will do is simply climb above it. And this is what happens if you've ever been on a plane which starts to enter an area of turbulence, then you hear the engine spool up a little bit and the plane, you can almost feel climbing. Well, that's exactly what's happening. The captain's just decided to climb the aircraft above the turbulence and find some clearer air above. However, if there's one thing you take away from this video, this is the thing that I want you to remember. Whenever you're seated on an aircraft, even if it's the clearest blue day out there and there isn't a breath of wind, always keep your seatbelt fastened. There's a reason why the crew and often the captain will tell you that over the PA system. Some turbulence just can't be seen by an aircraft, and sometimes, before you know it, it's too late and you're already in it. So please, whenever you're seated, always keep that seatbelt fastened, because you never know. Well, I hope you enjoyed that video and you did learn a thing or two about turbulence. If you've got any questions, do let me know in the comments below. Either myself or someone here in the brilliant flying community will jump on and hopefully answer your questions about turbulence. Thank you as always for watching. Give us a like if you enjoyed that content. And if you are new and you haven't subscribed already, don't forget there is a new flying and travel video that comes out every week. So be sure to subscribe. Otherwise, thank you again for watching. Have a fantastic weekend. Travel safe, and I'll catch you soon.